The Illuminati Formula to Create an Undetectable Total Mind Control Slave by Fritz Springmeier and Cisco Wheeler. Podcast 24. Chapter 12, The Science of External Controls. Continues. D. The Control of the Milieu. One of the basic ideas of creating a mind-controlled slave, is to control the entire milieu of the slave. This is expressed in Nexus 7. The environment of the slave is designed for what is called story immersion. A monarch slave who has been given the basic Alice in Wonderland and Wizard of Oz programming will see objects connected to these storylines in almost every store. Restaurants in Dallas and San Antonio, the Time Machine restaurants, which are used to reinforce programming, have mirrors on their walls, doors, and ceilings, and their waitresses dressed like programming script characters such as Dorothy of the Wizard of Oz. It is no accident that one of the leading satanic singers calls himself Ozzy Osbourne, or that a certain Mexican witch calls herself Oz. It is no accident that recently a witch wrote the book The Witches of Oz. It is no accident that the elite have promoted the Wizard of Oz theme with television product advertisements. It is no accident that the US has Oz stamps, that television has Oz cartoons, and Oz characters are appearing all over the place. For a while even Kansas had an Oz theme to their license plates, Land of AHS. Hillary Clinton, a sixth-level Illuminati witch and sadistic monarch slave handler, received a witch's hat in anticipation that she would be called the Wicked Witch of the West, and that Mary Matlin, who married Clinton's top campaign advisor James Carville, had a photograph of Hillary Clinton as the Wicked Witch of the West on her wall with the caption, "I will get you, my pretty, and your little dog too." The witch's hat and the caption both are popular with these people associated with the White House because they are so rich in triple and quadruple meanings. The deadliest meaning is that the monarch slaves that sexually service Hillary and Bill Clinton have Wizard of Oz programming. Hillary is really the Wicked Witch of the West. To these poor beta slaves. The constant bumping into Wizard of Oz paraphernalia or pictures of it helps focus the slave's mind onto their Wizard of Oz programming. MGM Grand recently built a multi-million-dollar pyramid complex with a theme park which is based on the Wizard of Oz and the Alice in Wonderland themes. The hotel at the MGM Grand is the world's largest with 5,000 rooms, which shows that mind control is big business. A team of actors dressed up in the Wizard of Oz theme like Dorothy and her friends, Tin Man and Scarecrow, and walked on a yellow brick road constructed in the MGM complex. Emerald City is part of the theme park. The complex cost $1 billion according to the Las Vegas Review-Journal, December 19, 93-page AL. This complex is given the occult name Luxor, and is at 3900 Las Vegas Boulevard South. It has been advertised as the next wonder of the world. It's a shame that the 1990s Big Wonder is a programming center. Another part of the control of the milieu is labeled planned spontaneity by the controllers. The monarch victim repeatedly finds experiences just happening. These are the coincidences that are so mystical that people feel there must be a higher significance to the event. Many of these are well-staged events. A slave may try to escape marrying the person they are commanded to marry. The handlers stay one step ahead of the slave, and through a series of coincidences introduce another acceptable person. The slave, in an effort to escape, grabs the first available substitute who has been coached on how to push all the correct green mental buttons to get the escapee to marry them. The slave jumps from the frying pan into the fire. Things which validate the programming and the mystical beliefs of the cult will be repeatedly introduced. The skill in introducing these secretly into the life of the slave are amazing. There is no limit to what can be attempted, and some of these staged events are worthy of Houdini. The occult world has placed their symbols all over the United States. The most esteemed institutions such as Walt Disney are fountains of the occult. Walt Disney movies are steeped in magic, and yet American society is so drowned in the occult, they have been desensitized to how it permeates American culture. The concept of sacred knowledge versus profane knowledge is introduced. If the slave should escape, the first choice is to send someone who can pick them up. I have heard of slaves escaping from Europe on the plane, only to be picked up by a handler when they land in New York. MT. Shasta's programming site, accessed by helicopter, specializes in reprogramming escaped slaves. Jerry Lee Lewis has a notorious reputation among the network as being exceptionally sadistic in reprogramming escapees. However, if the slave is not needed, and is wanting out, tens of thousands of them have been locked up in mental hospitals as paranoid schizophrenics. In the mental hospitals, they can continue to get drugs and electroshock, the very things that caused their problems in the first place. The insiders have a name for these slaves, they call them broken butterflies. If the slave tries to go to court, according to some, the non-compos mentis law prevents them from testifying against their abusers. At any rate, with or without this law, it would not be easy for a victim to get his testimony accorded the respect it deserves. If they get psychiatric help, their therapist cannot tell anyone about what they have suffered, and the therapist is hamstrung about what they can do in court for the client. Recently, 15 states have created statutes of limitations on sadistic rape. This is in response to all the monarch slaves who have begun recovering memories. The extent that entire culture and society protect the monarch programming is enormous. Anyone admitting multiple personality disorder, aka DID, is in fear of being labeled crazy and losing some of their rights and their job. Because the conspiracy, the network, is so vast, an examination of how the Illuminati controls society would be needed to cover the subject of milieu control. This would take an entire book. The reader is encouraged to read some of Fritz Springmeier's other works, which expose how the Illuminati's control extends over all levels of society. Most people have settled their minds on this issue without getting the facts. When the real facts are shown, it blows people's minds. Some of the easiest and everyday items to show people are simply a dollar bill with its Illuminati symbol on the back, and a can of vegetables which has a barcode on it. Every barcode has three secret and non-functional numbers in the barcode, which are 666. The silent hammer that strikes out at the monarch slave is that everywhere they go, the occult world is there. Several cars are named after Satan. The name Saturn and Bel Air are well known as occult names for Satan. When Freemasonry's greatest philosopher and Illuminati mind control programmer / Grand Druid Council member Manly P. Hall wrote Kabbalistic Keys to the Lord's Prayer, Los Angeles, California, The Philosophical Research Society, 1964, page 10, he wrote Saturn equals hallowed be thy name. The men who head these auto manufacturing companies are in the Illuminati. There is no question that they were not ignorant of the significance of these names. Many other occult names of big significance to the Illuminati involving eagles have been placed on cars. Electra is a recent car named after a demon. Viper is a slow and deadly creature, why would one want to use it to name a car? Viper is also the name of an important demon. Viper is found in Black Widow monarch slaves. Some readers may begin to feel that things are being stretched. The connections of numerous car names to the occult could be exposed, but that is not the purpose of this book. We will quote straight from a company their own explanation for their car's name in this next paragraph, simply to make the point, whether others perceive it or not, the monarch slaves have to exist in a world full of satanic / occult symbology that ordinary people don't understand. Mazda's president, Norimasa Furuta, published a book in 1990 which it intended to give to all its employees. The book explains its purpose. We have written a booklet to explain how Mazda became the name of our corporation and what it means in order to help everyone who is related to Mazda enhance their creativity and develop their potential. The book entitled The Globe, In Search of the Origins of Mazda, goes on to explain about the founder of Mazda Car Company, Matsuda Jujiro, who is heralded as a great seer who believed in himself, in his friends, and in heaven, and he achieved a truly global vision. Mazda Company's book, The Globe, then explains that the company name Mazda comes from the god Ahura Mazda, which was the god of light and the god of wisdom according to the book. Jujiro believed that Mazda represents the origin of civilization. The god of light, Lucifer, is often credited for starting civilization by those who aren't Christians. The name Mazda, according to the globe, symbolizes unlimited possibility and stimulates people's dreams. Mazda's book puts down in writing their New Age goals to establish peace for mankind with a global point of view, and a spiritual foundation toward which to work toward a new age. The book further states civilization started in Egypt and that Christianity evolved from the pagan mystery religions. Another book associated with Mazda cars, is the book The Meaning of Life, given to everyone who test drives a Mazda that was as long as book supplies last. I quote the book, "The time when regions and continents existed keeping a certain distance from each other is a thing of the past. We are eager to transmit the meaning of Mazda to the children of Mazda who will create a new Mazda. With a strong desire for peace and through the production and sale of automobiles and machine tools, Mazda has advanced on a course to unite the people of the world," Bold added, pages 78-79. An adept of the Illuminati is taught about Yahushuah Mazda. He would know that Mazda was the Persian god of light who was also known as Ormus, which is another name for the Priyar de Zion, which is a powerful group protecting the 13th Illuminati bloodline. Some of the names of cars which could be triggering to satanic ritual abuse survivors include the Demon, the Vagabond, Dodge Ram, Goat of Mendez, Buick's Phoenix, Ford's Cobra, Mercury's Cougar, Eagle Jeeps, the L.E. Baron Eagle logo, Navy Star Eagle truck, which may have Eagle mud flaps, and Goodyear Eagle GT tires. For most of us, an eagle is a symbol of what is noble and beautiful. Historically, the eagle and the snake have been the logo of the tribe of Dan, considered the black sheep of the 12 tribes. The prophet Hosea said, "Set the trumpet to thy mouth. He shall come as an eagle against the house of the Lord, because they have transgressed my covenant, and trespassed against my law." Hos 8:1, and the prophet Obadiah said, "Though thou exalt thyself as the eagle, and though thou set thy nest among the stars, thence will I bring thee down, saith the Lord." Obadiah 1:4, the co-authors of this book didn't create Illuminati history nor their symbols. We are only reporting on them. We would like the eagle simply to represent what is noble and fearfully made by God. Indeed, in some verses like in Isaiah, the eagle has a positive connotation. However, the construct, the refraining that is done by the Illuminati upon these symbols is that the eagle represents Satan's empire. The Assyrian, Roman, and Nazi empires used the eagle. The Illuminati point these things out to their initiates, and ask, "Is this a symbol of Christianity, or the power of our lineages which ruled those empires?" It is not the co-author's desire to interpret what Hosea and Obadiah meant. Nor is it our desire to dissuade anyone from buying the cars mentioned above. Our only point is that the survivor lives in a world of occult symbols and occult programming triggers. How do you convince someone to quit fearing the power of their abusers when it has its symbols on their money, their canned food, their cars, and their churches? Yes, there are such things as all-seeing eyes in some churches and Masonic logos on others, and other occult symbols. Hislop's The Two Babylons is devoted to showing all the pagan symbology in the Catholic Church. Are we exaggerating? Fritz went into one fast food restaurant and the cups and placemats had a wizard throwing occult energy balls with occult symbols. The next fast food place had placemats showing the King Arthur story, which is an extremely important myth for the Illuminati, the quest for the Grail. The next fast food place had placemats giving children instructions on how to hypnotize your parents. The next one had a Wizard of Oz theme, and the next one was selling occult movies. Fritz kept these placemats to use in his talks. This nation is immersed in the occult and so desensitized they don't realize it. The public thinks nothing of a gargoyle coloring an activity book. This type of thing is commonplace in American society. If one examines Golden Book's gargoyle coloring / activity book, 1995, still being sold, you will find gargoyle demons named after geographic locations that the child can color. You will find a magus with a book of spells that the child can color. For activities, the child can duplicate pictures, work codes, match shadows with their figures, match objects and images, and work with robot heads, of which several can be placed on one body. All these activities reinforce the type of skills that the programmers want children under mind control to have. The book has castles, robots, a sentence about a kitten which is a code about a computer disk, and mazes. A perfect book for the programmers to give a child, and the naive public walks by these kinds of books on their store shelves every day. The Illuminati's mind control goes on in part right in front of America's nose, and they don't see it. One of the saddest things for monarch mind control survivors is that the programmers are so systematic in destroying everything of beauty and value in life. Everything conceivable that can be degraded will be. This mind control has spread like an unseen cancer to every segment of life, and threatens to destroy this nation from the inside out. Imagine that every time you heard your own national anthem that it reinforced your mind control programming. That is the life of these victims of mind control. We wish the American people could realize that George Bush and Bill Clinton are on the same team. Both are descendants of the top 13 Illuminati bloodlines, both are totally corrupt morally, both are into the occult, and both were trained by the same person in subliminal language techniques NLP, neuro-linguistic programming. The best in subliminal language techniques is said to be Tony Robbins, and he is who the elite got to train both George Bush and Bill Clinton. Monarch mind-controlled slaves have been created since the late 1940s. Since the early 1960s, monarch slaves have been specially created for American presidents. These models are called presidential models. There are now living about 600 people, monarch slaves, who were created into presidential models. That is a large harem. Presidential models fit a particular set of physical standards, not one of the presidential sex slaves has been black. President Kennedy, Johnson, Nixon, Ford, Bush, Reagan, and Clinton have all been slave handlers. Many slaves have some deeper alters who have a realization that their presidents are in on the corruption. How does that make them feel? The cults which program pay particular attention to showing the child that men in police uniforms and ministers of churches are participating with the cult. This has the effect of embedding in the mind of the victim that there is no escape, that the entire structure of society is secretly in cahoots with the programmers. Not all policemen nor all ministers are dirty, but because of the monarch program, the entire structure of American society has been seriously compromised to the extent that all sectors are infiltrated and contaminated. Unfortunately, the worst fears of the victims are in reality close to the truth. The monarch victim is further victimized because no one wants to believe them in how controlled American society has become. The truth is we are on the verge of losing civilization as we know it, and entering into a dark sadistic slave master society that will make Hitler's Third Reich look like child play. What part of our lives are not controlled? We go to our jobs, our boss is naturally given the right to control us. For many centuries, the Machiavellian elite have provided the masses with bread and circus. That means keep the people fed and entertained and they will not rebel. After Americans come home, they are kept busy with entertainment. The only exception to their work, and TV watching, are their trips to their churches. Even the various religions are secretly under elite control. See Fritz's Be Wise as Serpents book for an 800-page expose of how the various Christian groups and New Age religions are controlled. The point is that people are kept busy and occupied, and they seldom try to step outside of the path that the elite want them to stay in. A slave's front system will be a normal busy person for years, while the deeper alters serve their various functions for the elite. There is simply little that occurs that shakes the routine that gets established. If the handler doesn't live with the slave himself, he will often place another slave as the spouse, to oversee the slave. The marriage couple's deeper alters spy on each other. The schools that the slaves will go to are often controlled by the abusers. Some of the more obvious ones are Groton, a school for the elite's children, and Santa Clara University and Willamette University, used by the Illuminati to train their politicians for public office. The Beta Theta Pi is a political fraternity through which quite a few Illuminati politicians have joined. The Jesuit schools throughout the United States are used for abuse and programming. Note, that Bill Clinton went to the Jesuit University in Washington, D.C. called Georgetown University. A number of the military school that parents ship their elementary boys off to are used by the elite for the ongoing abuse and programming of slaves. The Illuminati Foundation, the W.K. Kellogg Foundation, gave the initial funding for the Quest program for the public schools. The Quest program is being adopted by various public schools. It also goes by the name Skills for Adolescence, Skills for Growing, and Skills for Living. One of the early editions of Quest had an exercise called Elevator where the teacher uses visualization and guided imagery. The teacher places her school children in a mild hypnotic trance described in the Quest literature as a quiet contemplative mood. Then the teacher tells the students, "You are on an elevator. Each button on the elevator represents an age of the child. When the students push a button, the elevator takes them back to experiences at that age." It is not possible in the scope of this book to cover how every sector of our lives are controlled. Those who are interested need to read some of Fritz Springmeier's other writing, including Be Wise as Serpents. However, it would be appropriate to cover how television shows and Hollywood are intimately linked to monarch mind control programming. A great deal that is coming out of Hollywood is linked to mind control in some fashion. Some of the hottest entertainers are monarch slaves, such as Madonna, a Marilyn Monroe replacement. Co-author Fritz was given a catalog to Vitamax, which is a New Jersey occult porn video club, by someone wanting to help his research. This cult video club actually sells snuff films. They sell the real-life footage of cannibalism, virgin sacrifices, occult rituals, and worse. When Madonna was a teenage slave with the name Louise Chic Cone living in New York East Village, a real-life film was made of her being raped, a setup, and then her cult family taking the rapist and sacrificing him. Vitamax sells this for $19 to their members. Some of their videos are live footage of how kidnapped people have been tortured into becoming slaves. One of the catalog listings says, "Tortured until their wills are broken and they become Olga's submissive slaves." Warning: extreme graphic violence, backed by popular demand. By the way, the Illuminati have their own private porn distribution. Many people ask, why do they need mind-controlled slaves? Part of the answer is they need them to make their sick porn. The history of the connections between the entertainment world and the occult and royalty go far back. One group of people known for their traveling entertainment, the Gypsies, have some interesting parallels with the Illuminati bloodlines. A Gypsy proverb is, "If you want to stay survive, you must be a devil." Both groups have kept their bloodlines and their identity. Both are secretive. Both groups live double lives. Gypsy children will be given a secret magical name, and a name to use for outsiders. Gypsy children are often baptized in a magical circle. Both groups are into the occult, such as cannibalism, black magic, the evil eye, and white slavery. The Gypsies believe in Karani, a big bird consumed by fire who rises from the ashes. The Illuminati call this the Phoenix. Both groups have a secret code that allows them to do anything to outsiders, who are called Gaja by Gypsies, meaning enemy. The Gypsies originated in India and migrated west to Iran and Turkey and then to Greece and then into Western Europe in the 1400s, just prior to an occult revival in Europe. The largest Gypsy tribe in India is Gur. They follow Durga, Kali. Other tribes also worship Kali under different names, such as the Black Virgin, for which they make an effigy called Bibi Eka, which simply means lady. Gypsies made up early groups of traveling entertainers. Sir Francis Bacon, who wrote under the pen name of Shakespeare, was the founder/leader of the Rosicrucians of his time. The proof of who Shakespeare was is in several books. For instance, see Alfred Dodd's research in his excellent book Francis Bacon's Personal Life Story. The previous two paragraphs are offered as examples of how close the occult world and entertainment have been over the centuries. The history of the two worlds coincide for many centuries back, so it shouldn't come as a surprise that today's entertainment industry is still closely linked to the occult world, nor should it come as a surprise that the Illuminati have made sure they have control over the industry. During WW2, the entire country was mobilized for the war effort and Hollywood was recruited, so to speak, to help with the war effort. For instance, cartoons were created as training films and as war propaganda. The military hired thousands of entertainers for USO Camp Shows Incorporated, which was under the Special Services Division of the U.S. Army. Bob Hope, who worked for MI6, British Overseas Intelligence, was the leading entertainer for USO tours. After the war broke out, he went on 12 major overseas tours, which took him and his beautiful troupe of stunning knockout girls to every front of the war, from the quiet fronts like Panama to places like Italy and North Africa. To make a long story short, Bob Hope was used to run messages to programmed multiples for British and American intelligence. Later, after the war, Bob Hope became a slave handler. In some of Fritz's other writings, Bob Hope's connections to the Illuminati are gone into. USO Magicians were found to be the most overall popular USO show. The International Brotherhood of Magicians is intimately connected to the occult world and puts out a magazine, The Linking Ring. Under the auspices of the USO, controlled by military intelligence, the country Western industry's roots developed. The country Western industry became a front for drug running, money laundering, and white slavery for the programmers of monarch total mind-controlled slaves. The USO also created at least 200 bands, from which came Lawrence Welk's band, Sam Donahue's band, Claude Tombill's band, and Guy Lombardo's band, to name a few. Over the last 45 years, perhaps the most popular place for couriers to be signaled to meet was by someone holding a bird in a cage or at a shop with bird cages. The allusion to carrier pigeons is so obvious. Look at a caption speaking of wrens with a cartoon from Bob Hope's book I Never Left Home, New York, Simon & Schuster, 1944, written in 1944 during the middle of WW2. The cartoon shows Bob chasing a girl with a birdcage and saying, "Tweet, tweet, tweet." Hypnotic commands are given 3 times. What seems like a harmless cartoon is more like a signal telling people that Bob Hope is in charge of a flock of carrier pigeons, couriers, which we know he was. When talking to a group of soldiers during the war, Bob said, "In London, the Bobbies caught a guy walking around in the fog with a birdcage giving the mating call, but the American Council got me." Walter Boward, in his researcher's edition of Operation Mind Control, discusses the case of 2 WW2 vets, who had their WW2 memories erased by the military using drugs, hypnosis, and behavior modification, before they were released from the Army in 1947. This is found in Cassidy, Karen, and Judith A. Lyons. Recall of Traumatic Memories Following Cerebral Vascular Accident, Journal of Traumatic Stress. New York, Plenum Pub. Volume 5, No. 4, October 1992, page 627. The point is that evidence is surfacing from various locations that the U.S. government was carrying out mind control during WW2. This was done under the auspices of British intelligence, MI6. During WW2. When Canada entered the WW2 with Britain, one of the best British secret agent training schools was set up between Whitley, Ontario, and Oshawa, Ontario, on Lake Ontario's north shore across from the U.S.-Canadian border. The site was called Intrepid Park. Agents called it the camp or the farm. Today, the CIA have their own farm, Camp Peary. The official British name for this spy camp was British Security Coordination Special Training School No. 103 and Hydra. STS 103. It was also known as Camp X. British SO, Special Operations Executive, set itself in NYC. Americans from the FBI and OSS went to Camp X for training, as well as the SOCIS, BSC, and the Canadian RCMP. The British were already using mind control at this stage. The connections are endless. Edgar Allan Poe, who was into the occult and worked for British intelligence, wrote The Raven. Vincent Price starred in Hollywood's version of The Raven, and passages of the book have been used as codes for a number of monarch slaves, who had to memorize portions of the book with their photographic memories. Warner Communications came out with the book / and movie Sybil, which is about a woman with multiple personalities. The book and movie Sybil are full of mental slides. Misinformation detours are called slides by the CIA, to prevent people from looking and thinking in the right directions concerning MPD. Structured MPD, DID, like Sybil's, occurs only from very specific trauma-based programming. Even the name Sybil is an occult name, although the idea that a cult was involved in creating Sybil's MPD is not hinted at. The chief financial power behind Warner Communications was the Illuminati / Pilgrim Society member Eugene R. Black, retired head of the World Bank. Warner Communications is headquartered at Rockefeller Plaza, and has produced quite a few occult movies and occult books, for instance their movie about a demon It Lives Again. When monarch slaves watch television, the shows they watch can relate to their programming in the following ways. 1. First, many of the shows have code words or programming scenarios which are deliberately in the shows to control the slaves, such as Star Wars, Star Trek, The Wizard of Oz, The Love Boat, Fantasy Island, I Dream of Genie, Delta Genie in the Bottle programming, and Your Wish is My Command type trigger, The Little Princess, The Miss Universe Contest 1995, DuckTales, created to control child slaves, with deliberate triggers such as Earthquake, Bobby's World cartoon, Steven Spielberg's Tiny Toons, My Fair Lady, used in several of the slave finishing schools, E.T., for alien programming, etc. 2. Some of the shows which are supposedly pure fiction show elements of actual Illuminati ceremonies, Illuminati history, drug running methods, etc., such Bell, Book, and Candle, Burn Witch Burn, Curse of the Voodoo, Equinox, Manos, The Hands of Fate, Witchcraft 70, As Spirits of the Living Dead, Frankenstein, Night of the Living Dead, Bewitched, with actual witches as actors. Raising Cain shows torture and MPD. Hellraiser 3 depicts gatekeepers. 3. Some of the shows portray the Monarch Total Mind Control Program, Telephone, The Manchurian Candidate, Videodrome, Labyrinth, Transfer 2, The Attack of the Robots, Dr. Goldfoot and the Bikini Machine, Attack of the Puppet People, The War of the Zombies, Colossus the Forbidden Project, and The Point of No Return starring Jane Fonda's Bridget, who is connected to the Odo. By the way, Monarch mind-controlled slaves have been shown the movie Telephone to emphasize to them that their minds are controlled by their handlers, and for them not to forget it. For many of the movies and shows use monarch slaves as actors and performers, such as Roseanne Barr, Bette Midler, Marilyn Monroe, Loretta Lynn, Crystal Gayle, and possibly Wayne Newton, a child singing protege, who never wrote a check for himself in his life. They also use lots of slave handlers such as Frank Sinatra, Peter Lawford, and Bob Hope. And occasionally they use programmers such as Anton Levy, Jerry Lee Lewis, Cisco Wheeler, the co-author of this book, while in the Illuminati, was given repeated reason to believe that Elvis Presley was also a multiple programmed by the Illuminati. We know that at times he went by code names, one which is publicly known was John Burroughs. His group, called the Memphis Mafia, have talked about his ability to go into altered states of consciousness, even seem dead. Recently, another Illuminati slave, also stated that Elvis was an Illuminati slave. Cisco points out that Elvis' twin brother was dead at his birth, and that Elvis knew that this gave him double spiritual power, according to Illuminati beliefs. The Illuminati will often kill a twin, so that the other will get the power of two souls. From what we understand, Elvis Presley's handler / programmer was a COL. Tom Parker. Elvis belonged to a team of 4 Illuminati men. Elvis is publicly known to have studied yoga, numerology, drugs, and received some New Age spiritual training in an academy overlooking Pasadena, California. He was an active member in the Theosophical Society. After Elvis Presley supposedly died, the Sun International Corp. came out with an Elvis Presley album called Orion, with the Winged Sun Disc on its cover. The Winged Sun Disc is an important Egyptian magical symbol used by the OTO. Ordo Templi Orientis, satanic occult organization founded by German occultist Karl Kellner in 1896, Theosophical Society, etc. Mayborn Axton, known as the Grand Dame of Nashville, played a pivotal role in Elvis Presley's life. Elvis and the Beatles were chosen by the Illuminati to introduce rock music to the United States. There is no doubt about Elvis and the Beatles' musical talent. Elvis' close friend Wayne Newton is highly suspected as also being a slave. Elvis worked with Burt Reynolds and Jerry Lee Lewis, who also connect in with the Illuminati's mind control operations. The authors are puzzled why Elvis' grave, which had millions of dollars spent on its security, has his name misspelled. We are also puzzled why Elvis, who repeatedly stated he wanted to be buried beside his mother, is buried beside his father, who he privately stated wasn't even his real father. Why has no one ever tried to collect insurance on Elvis' death? Once again, it seems, the front stories that the public hears are full of inconsistencies. We believe that some people in the Illuminati know the true story about Elvis Presley. For sure, Elvis' mysterious mind control programmer slash handler col. Tom Parker would know. Star Trek, The Next Generation. The original series of Star Trek had lost money, but in September 1987 a new series called Star Trek, The Next Generation was started with $1 million budgeted for each of its 24 episodes. The episodes pushed the Illuminati's agenda in every show. People were being aroused to bombard Paramount with requests for a new Star Trek. Bob Justman, who worked with Gene Roddenberry, said, "When I left Star Trek in 1968, it was a disaster. It was a failure as far as the network was concerned. That is because it didn't make money. Hollywood tells us it makes these movies because they are what the public want and that they have to go where the money is. The closer truth is that Hollywood makes movies that push an agenda. Hollywood makes movies that Hollywood wants to make. And since Star Trek was part of the NWO's mind control, the show and its successors had to go on." How important is Star Trek? A witness has talked about Boeing workers sneaking off their jobs and hiding in the tunnels underneath the huge Seattle Boeing plant so they could watch Star Trek shows. This enormous Boeing plant is used for rituals and mind control. This Boeing building is enormous, for it is where they have assembly lines to build the huge jets, like the 747s, 707s, etc. An extensive maze of tunnels lays underneath the main building, large enough to accommodate all the tens of thousands of workers on any shift. It is interesting who was associated with the production of Star Trek, The Next Generation. Script writers for The Next Generation had a Star Trek Bible to write from. These script writers included such persons as Alan Adler, Dennis Putnam Bailey, Three Grays, Deborah McKeln Try, Ronald Moore, Grant Rosenberg, Randy Russell, Brian Stewart. These are common names within the Illuminati. Coca-Cola, an Illuminati-run corporation, was one of the major advertisers for Star Trek, and the godman Dalai Lama of Tibet, who is a Star Trek fan, visited the cast of Star Trek in 1988 in Hollywood and got his picture taken with members of the cast. Probert, who worked with Star Trek Productions, also worked with Walt Disney's Imagineering subsidiary. Here are some of the Star Trek scenes. A Wizard of Oz head is shown on a show. Data is a humanoid with an on-off switch who can store vast amounts of data. His memories can be so strong that personalities in those memories fight for control of data. See the episode aired January 23, 89. Holodeck creations of people, humans who are mirror images, who are aware of themselves. This is a well-used concept for programming monarch alters. The first episode with this aired 1/1188 and got several awards, an Emmy Award, and an award from the George Foster Peabody Award Board. A few other items which will show the reader the occult agenda of Star Trek, The Next Generation and how it fits into the mind control programming, airing dates shown in parenthesis. 1. A reptilian race called Telesians, 10/12/1987. 2. A cosmological egg from the Kabbalistic magical worldview, 10/26/1987. 3. A brain scanned by a probe, 11/9/1987. 4. Age regression. 5. Reverse aging and memory loss, 2/8/1988. 6 Android Duels and a Crystalline Body, 1/18/1988. 7 A Race of Computer Operators, 2/1/1988. 8 An Ozone Hole in the Atmosphere Kills a Planet, 2/15/1988. 9 A Matriarchal Oligarchy Shades of the Mother of Darkness's Oligarchy, 1/25/1988. 10 People Who Are Only Holographic Projections, 4/11/1988. 11 A Cyberneticist and Androids, 2/13/1989. 12 Doubles, Mirror Images, 4/3/1989. 13 Half-Human Half-Robot People, 5/8/1989. 14 Clones of People, 5/22/1989. 15 A Holodeck Person Who Doesn't Know His Last Name, 6/19/1989. 16 Betazoids, 11/13/1989, and A Drug Which Causes Hysterical Paranoia, 7/17/1989. Colorado. Colorado is the area where trauma-based alien theme programming is carried out with a mock UFO. Gaston, one of the programmers in that area, is turning out top-secret monarchs with solometric systems. NORAD and Colorado Springs and several other Colorado locations are major headquarters for end-time callback programming. Interestingly, they have placed the Star Trek fan club in Colorado. Videodrome. This recent movie portrays monarch mind control and S&M sadism and masochism. Mind-controlled slaves are frequently used to create S&M films. The Illuminati's S&M porn film industry has been booming for over 4 decades. Compare the name Videodrome with Vitamax mentioned above. The porn films done of a particular monarch slave who is used as a porn star will be coded according to the code name given to the star. Let's say they call the star Lily, then the porn movies will be cataloged Lily 1, Lily 2, Lily 3, etc. This type of porn involves a great deal of real torture, humiliation, and actual deaths of people. This type of porn is portrayed in the Hollywood movie Videodrome. The main character in Videodrome represents what a mind-controlled slave would see. The main character Max is told, "I want you to open up to me." He then feels intense pain and doubles up and falls down, and submits, "All right." Then he is ordered to give us Channel 83. He then proceeds under the mind control to kill 2 partners, who he has previously liked and with whom he has had no quarrels. He is further told, "You are an assassin for Videodrome. They can program you. They can make you do what they want." Interestingly, the name of the brand of cigars smoked on the show are named Medici's. He is told, "To become the new flesh you must kill the old flesh." This is the type of suicide programming given monarch slaves. He is ordered, "Come to Mickey." Mickey happens to be part of Mickey Mouse programming and one of the nicknames of the programmer Michael Aquino. He is then shown a picture of suicide. Then the hypnotic command, "Come to Mickey," is said 3 times. Long live the new flesh. The movie announces, "The battle for the mind of North America will be fought in Videodrome." Trancer 2. This is also billed as a cult classic. Who decides what is a cult classic? At any rate, this is another film which depicts part of the monarch total mind control. We will not take the space to cover it in depth, but we'll touch on a few items here. The main character is McNulty, which sounds a lot like MK Ultra. Is it a play on words? It could be. A council like the Illuminati's with lifetime appointments is in the film. The persons under control in Trancer 2 bear some resemblance to the monarchs. Some of the language that is used is lifted from the language that handlers use. "Follow my instructions, sleep, sleep, sleep," a person is instructed. Rabbit speaking, "You belong in a green world." The movie also has freeze codes which are a color. Krull. This 1983 movie with Ken Marshall and Lysette Anthony is just one more example of hundreds of Hollywood movies which show some aspect of the Illuminati and slash or their mind control. Krull is an island ruled by sorcery. A prince searches for a magic ornament to save his bride and their kingdom. The film has a poppy field, castles, an all-seeing eye, armies of robots, Satan, and other features that a monarch internal world will be set up with. A person can turn into a dog, pig, or lion. The Little Princess. This Shirley Temple movie was just one of many Hollywood films used for programming. The princess has a nice dream. Slaves are programmed to view their service in the real world as dreams, and their fantasy worlds in their internal mind as reality. The princess has a scene with hot cross buns and ravens. This scene was used for programming. The princess sits on a throne. There are fairies and a joker, which are used in programming. The father is said to be dead, but is not dead in this movie, thus creating the type of reversal that the programmers like to work into the minds of slaves. A rich genie helps the princess, and when she finds her daddy, she wakes him up with a kiss and a song. The girl's name is Sarah, a name which appears within a number of monarch systems as an alter name. Miss Universe Contest. The broadcast of the 1995 Miss Universe Contest did a very unusual freeze framing of the show while it was on. The screen was mysteriously freeze framed 9 times. This was a trigger for Illuminati Mothers of Darkness altars. A Mother of Darkness type throne was sat upon by the winner of the contest. An all-seeing eye was flashed up on the screen with the code AMAZING written on it. This is the type of puns that the programmers enjoy. The winners of the contest came from India, Canada, and the USA. The order and names of those countries have to do with end times programming. The names were a code to certain Mothers of Darkness systems. India wore a Mother of Darkness type garment. Canada wore black and white, and USA wore red. Miss India gave another code during the interviews: if someone wants to put monkeys on your back, if you stand up they get on your back. The Manchurian Candidate. In 1958, the author Richard Condon had his novel The Manchurian Candidate published, which describes an American army sergeant, who is captured and programmed to assassinate on the cue of a queen of diamonds of a deck of cards. Richard Condon's ability to think about the potential of behavior modification and hypnosis had allowed him to stumble upon what had actually been going for over a decade. Frank Sinatra bought the movie rights for this book, let the movie out briefly, and then squelched the second release of the film. Frank Sinatra has been a slave handler. He has handled Bob Hope's slaves, when Bob Hope has lent them to the Rat Pack, which consisted of Dean Martin, Frank, Sammy Davis, Jr., Peter Lawford, and Joey Bishop. Frank Sinatra spends time with the Rockefellers and the Rothschilds. Both he and Dean Martin have handled slaves. Dean Martin was described by the Hollywood Reporter as a hypnotically attractive, homegrown American monster. In Fritz's previous writings, he has exposed how Peter Lawford and Sammy Davis, Jr. were Satanists. Dean had the audacity to want to bring out a monarch slave on his TV show on a leash in a tiger outfit. As mentioned previously, the sexual alters see themselves as kittens or cats and are given obedience training with the type of collar Dean wanted to bring them out on stage with on television. The television network stopped it. As Frank Sinatra grew up, his parents always had money. His mother was a cigar-smoking, cruel, and foul-mouthed woman who performed illegal abortions. She got caught once and had to face the penalty on February 27, 1939 in a Hudson Special Sessions Court. Frank's hero was Benjamin Bugsy Siegel, boss of Murder Incorporated. About 30% of the dirty work for the Illuminati is carried out by the Mafia. The Illuminati have their own death squads which are superior to the Mafia, but individuals must approach one of the Illuminati councils for approval to assassinate. Often it is easier for someone in the Illuminati just to put out an unauthorized contract than to go through proper channels. Bugsy associated with all the Mafia heads, including Charlie Lucky Luciano, who controlled mind-controlled slave Marilyn Monroe. Both Frank Sinatra and CIA mind control programmer William Joseph Bryan, Jr., aka William Joseph Bryan, and William Jennings Bryan III, etc., were members of the Tommy Dorsey Band. Bryan programmed people while he was with the Air Force as Chief of Medical Survival Training, which was the Air Force's covert mind control section. Later he opened up his own hypnotherapy institute on Sunset Strip in Hollywood, where he programmed some people in the Illuminati who are actors. He also was the person who programmed Sirhan Sirhan to be involved in the Robert Kennedy assassination. He also hypnotized Albert DeSalvo. After Brian died in spring 1977, the CIA cleaned out all of his files, including his home files. Brian was fat, 6 feet 1.5 inches tall, and a satanic priest in the old Roman Catholic Church. This is the same satanic church that William Schnoeblen was a satanic priest in, before giving his life to Christ. Bill Schnoeblen tells his own story in Lucifer Dethroned. Chino, C.A., Chick Publications, 1993. Schnoeblen was offered a slave, but turned down the opportunity to be a handler. In William J. Bryan, Jr.'s book entitled The Chosen One: The Art of Jury Selection, Bryan teaches how to use hypnosis on jury members to win one's case. On the back of the book he states about himself, "In addition, Dr. Bryan served as an electronics engineer in the Navy in World War II, was director of all medical survival training for the United States Air Force, and a leading expert on brainwashing." William J. Bryan was the technical director for Frank Sinatra's movie The Manchurian Candidate. It was hoped that the movie would scare Americans into thinking that the enemy, the communists, was carrying out mind control. The Simpson cartoons. There are episodes of The Simpsons which blatantly promote the Freemasons, the Illuminati, and even show items of the monarch mind control, such as following the yellow brick road. The episodes are quite revealing. Aspects of Illuminati programming can also be seen in the movie Spirits of the Dead, where spirit copies of one's abusers are placed into the slave, and the movie Catgirl, where a beautiful girl is turned into a killer beast. Several movies have come out showing the concept of creating robotic people, such as the 1920s movie Golem, the 1966 movie Cyborg 2087, and the movie Frankenstein. According to Illuminati history, the Collins Illuminati bloodline did pre-2th century experiments to create a Frankenstein, and Mary Shelley's novel is actually secretly based on their research also. Clive Collins may have been the name of the actor who played the role of the mad scientist who created the Frankenstein monster in the original 1930s movie starring Boris Karloff. The Rothschilds have carried out successful production of synthetic people this century. This is all in accord with the black magic goal of controlling bodies, whether live or dead. The 90-minute film, Night of the Living Dead, expresses the satanic black magic goal to control bodies. And if the Illuminati can't control their slaves, the final solution, if nothing else works, is to, as the CIA say, terminate with extreme prejudice, a.k.a. executive action, like they did to Mary Pinchot Meyer on October 13, 1964, Princess Grace Kelly and countless others. E. Twinning and bonding. Two sisters of light, the level before mothers of darkness, will be placed before a many-faced mirror with intense lights and programmed to see each other as inseparable. They become twins, and are programmed to die if the other one dies. They are taught to be one in body, mind, and soul. They are bonded in many ways, including torturing each other, and sexual bonding. The trauma bonding that they undergo will consist of A. being put in life or death situations together, B. given programming scripts which intertwine and fill in to complete each other to make a whole, C. are placed in jobs that require total compliance with the programming in order to survive, D. are bonded together to other people. The scripture "A house divided against itself cannot stand," Matthew 12:25, Mark 3:25, is used to program people to stay in line with what the team is doing. High-level four-person female teams and a four-person males team are programmed to work together after the Antichrist takes over. These types of teams form the male-female component of a larger three-part team. With the advent of advanced medical technology, the Illuminati are now able to make quintuplets, implant the eggs in surrogates, and then switch the identical children during their lifetimes. This type of high-level subterfuge is going on, and it makes the identities of some slaves complicated, to say the least. Readers may want to get some of the articles Fritz has written about the clones, synthetic people, organic robotoids, and double lookalikes that the Rothschilds and the rest of the Illuminati families are engaged in creating. The twinning programming is very complex and detailed. Within the Rothschild bloodlines, the five family lines that began with Meyer Emschel's five sons going to five capitals network slash bond their female slaves together with Jennifer Sally Elsie Sarah Penelope programming. The sixth son to finish the red-skilled hexagram is slash was a bastard. This is all part of a complex satanic world mind that is being created. This is the Adam Cadman. Twins, and teams, claim to be telepathic with each other, and observations of slaves, has tended to support that claim. Many therapists have failed to take the twinning part of the programming into account. Twins must be deprogrammed together for best results. If one is left out, they may try to impede therapy. F. Peer pressure. At the beginning of the programming, the programmers are dealing with a small infant who is unable to verbalize to others about their abuse. They are further frightened in every way, and tortured, and given behavior modification to teach them to remain silent. Even without all these strong threats which always exist, the child would not capable of fighting back. The child will naturally think this is the way the world is, and of course, the programmers are reinforcing the idea that this is the heritage or path that the child is supposed to be following. The dissociative parts of the child do not fully comprehend that being sexually assaulted daily by their father is wrong. They are being misled by their abuser that it is correct, that that is their purpose in life. The child is never given a chance to realize that it has a right to refuse. It is conditioned to obedience. The abuse seems to be just another part of things that belong to the world of adults. For children, adults do many things beyond comprehension, at times ridiculous. And they seem to need no reason to do these things, except for the fact that they are adults. Other adults that come and go are also participants in the abuse, so the child doesn't grasp that he can be defended by other adults. The programmers are always doing unexpected things to the child, so the child quits trying to figure life out, and fatalistically complies with what it is expected to do. Children all over the world grow up in an adult world, and are at the mercy of adults. As the alters begin to experience life, they are generally in situations where the attitudes of the people around them reinforce their programming. Boys are told by society in general to take their lumps in life like a man. They are taught to fight their own battles, and not to whine. Few boys risk the shame that comes from talking about their abuse. Society is not kind to winners. Females are permitted to show emotions, without the social sanctions levied on males. If the child victim of mind control comes from a family where only one of the parents is a participant in the abuse, then what often happens is that the clean parent will never even discuss abuse issues with their child. Few adults ever really discuss abuse issues with children. The child is generally isolated from their peers as much as possible by the child's handlers and programmers. They place other children that belong to the cult in the child's life to report on what the child is doing. When the child victim begins to stretch their wings, so to speak, and meet other people, there are very few people that will threaten the control of the programmers. When the slave does find a good therapist to make friends with, this friendship will trigger all kinds of programming, unresolved issues around adults, trust, etc. The slave feels double-binded. If they move toward health and freedom, it creates many more problems than staying in slavery. They need to see the bigger picture. They need to be given something positive to live for outside of the slavery. Psychiatrists are not permitted by their boards to get personally involved in their clients' lives. Traditional therapy doesn't address some of the issues that will stop the slave from wanting to gain freedom. Internal peer pressure from multitudes of programmed loyal deeper alters, and external peer pressure from cult children the victim is bonded to, begins to exert an overpowering force for the child to stay on the beaten path. Few people ever buck the system, and go against peer pressure. Someone as hurt and docile as a slave is going to want acceptance, and is not likely going to want to step out of line with society and their peers. Until society admits that there is a problem with mind control, it will be a dangerous thing socially for a child slave to admit to what the victim is actually experiencing every day. Are there any Hagabards or Mrs.'s? Now the reader has the formula for the mind control. Now what? These programmed multiples continue to eat away at the moral fiber every one of America's institutions like an army of termites. On the outside the structures still look strong, but they are being readied to collapse, for the reign of the Illuminati's Antichrist. There is a series of books called the Illuminati books which are a fictional account of how the Illuminati run the world. In the novels, the Illuminati run essentially everything, which is actually what is happening. The hero, Hagabard, fights against this ancient conspiracy. Who isn't familiar with the biblical example of the elite ruler, who leaves his place of royalty to lead a nation in slavery to freedom? This hero's name is Moses. He also frees the people spiritually from the spiritual bonds of their hermetic magical culture. If there are any Hagabards or Moses or Aarons out there, it is time to buck this world system. Let our people go. Let our children go. Thus saith Yahuwah, let my people go, that they may serve me. Exodus 8:1.